Hi, my name is Carolina Arbelais, and I will be your nutritional go-to girl with OcalaBread.com. I actually went to Delaware Valley University in Pennsylvania. It's a small private ag business college. My major was large animal science with equestrian studies and business. I've worked in the equine nutrition field for several years, and you'll be spending hopefully lots of time with me coming up, getting some quick tips and nutritional information for your horses. Hi guys, I'm Carolina Arbelais with OcalaBread.com and Carolina's Corner. So we've discussed so far how to weigh your hay, how to weigh your feed. Next piece of the puzzle is we really need to actually do a body condition score on your horse and how to get your horse's weight. Today we're going to be using the Hennecke scale, which is a 1 to a 9, and 1 being severely emaciated, 9 being morbidly obese basically, right? So when you're looking at your horse to do an overall body condition score, there are certain parts of your horse you're going to look at. The evaluation is actually almost opposite muscles and opposite parts of your horse than you would for your top line evaluation score, which we'll discuss at another point. For your body condition score, you're looking for fat pockets through here. You're then going to take your hand, follow it down your horse's body, and come into the point right here behind your shoulder. Depending on how much your hand sinks in is going to tell you basically how much fat is on there. This is also a point where you want to come right through here and look straight down your horse's body, right through the barrel. See if you can actually palpate any ribs. Ideally, you should be able to see a couple depending on how your horse is standing and palpate them very easily. He's a little harder to palpate, so we might be getting a little pudgy. From there, you actually want to follow through the point of the hip. And then also the rounding of the croup. Once you're at the point of your croup, have somebody else hold your horse for safety. Ask if it's not your horse, if it's a kicker or not a kicker. What you're looking for is the halo through here, as well as if you stand on your tippy toes, you would see a little bit of a dimple right there of a little fat pocket. Depending on, literally, they will round up like this when they're very overweight in the hind end, and you'll actually, it'll make the shape of an apple. So now we've looked at all of the parts where you're going to palpate. The next thing you're going to want to do is actually score it. Again, from a 1 to a 9, ideal range is in between a 4 and a 6, which takes into consideration the different disciplines and the ideal body weight for your different disciplines. So through here, he doesn't really have very much. He's not overweight at all in his neck. I would give him a 5 through here. Through here, I would give him a 5 1/4 maybe. Maybe keep a little bit of an eye on what's going on right through his barrel. Know that maybe just like people, this is where he's gonna keep most of his weight. Through the hip, we have nice coverage. I'd want almost a little bit more, but again, this is a 2-year-old, right? So we know that he's gonna change and muscle up once he's in work. His hind end, what you're seeing is here is not much of a halo, right? He's only 2, and so he's not in heavy work. And there's really no dimpling. So I would give him about a 4.5, which brings your average as a whole to a 5, which actually comes right into the range of the ideal. It's just good to know where your horse is in the different quadrants, because in the future, if things change, it gives you an opportunity to know where to assess muscling versus fat. The very last part of this is you're gonna wanna figure out how much your horse weighs, because when we're feeding your horse, right? Most manufacturers feed tags go off of how much your horse weighs. It's really simple. There's so many different ways to do it. Most people don't have commercial scales. And I personally like to use the heart girth times body length formula. Why? Because if I lose my weight tape, then I can just use any regular tape measure, actually. So you'd come in right from here is where you would start your weight tape. Or your regular measuring tape if you've lost it, like I do all the time. And then you would run it taut all the way through here and come in to the point of his buttock right about here. That's going to be your length. Your heart girth, you would measure, obviously, all the way around, and you would take it to here. Now, on the instructions, almost every time it'll tell you to take it to where the hair ends. However, keep in mind that when you do this, if you have a lot of space in between here, this is going to add extra pounds that your horse probably doesn't have if he's got a little bit of a shark fin and is starting to develop into work. So I usually really tighten it almost to the point that I leave a little bit of a dent because I want a truer read. What you would do is take your heart girth times your heart girth times your length, and you divide it by 330 on an adult horse, 301 on a yearling, and 280 on a weanling. That'll give you your horse's weight in pounds. So now, with today and these past 5 minutes, you figured out how to do a body condition score and how to get your horse's body weight. So now when you read your tag and it tells you to feed half a pound for every 100 pounds your horse weighs, you know exactly how much to feed him. And when you want to do your 2% of your horse's body weight in hay, you know exactly how much hay you want to feed your horse as well. Again, thanks so much for tuning in to Carolina's Corner with OcalaBred.com, and hopefully I will see you again soon. Thanks, bye.